What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Jonathan Yamadua here, welcoming you back to another episode of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. In the last episode, we struggled at the very, not the tail end, I don't know where we are in the trial, but we struggled at this part of this trial, where we're trying to determine who got killed twice. Like, that is the big thing that we have to determine. Now, my thought process is that it was Leon or Junko, because of the murder and the way that things happened.
Was it Sayaka Maizono?
Like, there's no way it was Sayaka. Could have been Junko, because he actually killed Junko. Mondo Owada? So, like, I actually am inclined to almost go with Junko first, but no. It's just, like, everything being hidden on the top half. Or maybe Sakura. Could it have been Sakura? That would be crazy. There's no way anyone was murdered twice. Okay, no. I might have actually even tried that possibility.
Who is this someone else? Was it Sayaka Maizono?
Yeah, no what? No.
Junko Enoshima? Leon Kuwata? Chihiro Fujisaki? Mondo Owada?
Is that why it would have blown up?
Kiyotaka Ishimaru? Hifumi Yamada? Celestia Lu? Whatever? Or maybe Sakura Ogami? No. There's no way anyone was murdered twice!
Oh my. No! I hit my button mashed. Oh no. No. That's not what I meant to do. Yes, we want to pull Junko's name out of the hat because she was the only one that Monokuma actually killed. So theoretically speaking, she could have pulled Junko's body out again. Monokuma.
Lou, whatever. Or maybe Sakura Ogami? No. There's no way anyone was murdered.
There we go, chat. We did it. Okay. Freaking finally.
Wasn't her fatal injury pretty similar to Mukuro's?
So I did it in opposite order. Okay, good job, me. Really good job, me. Literally the second person I tried to do Makuro's fatal injuries with Junko, and that didn't work, so I got let off the trail. Good job, Monokuma.
What do you mean?
Well, remember what happened to her? She was impaled by a bunch of spears. All over her body.
And Mukuro died from a number of wounds across her body. When you compare that to the stab wounds Junko suffered,
then the similarities match?
Yes, and those are the only fatal injuries that match up. That explains why those two bodies are actually one and the same.
So let me see if I have this straight. Junko, or someone going by that name, was stabbed to death with multiple spears. Then her body was kept in the bio lab for however long before being dragged out again. Only this time, it was presented as the corpse of one Mukuro Ikusaba.
It all matches up, right? Those wounds Junko suffered could easily be these same injuries.
Then, it's really true? Mukuro and Junko are the same person? Wait, so then, what does it all mean?
It means that there haven't been 10 victims, but 9. Which also means that among the people we thought were dead, one is still alive.
And that's the true identity of the mastermind?
Who is it? Who's behind all this?
We already know the answer to that. It's Mukuro. She's still alive! She took Junko's body and made it look like she was the one who died! Mukuro is still alive! She's gotta be! Total silence? Then I must be right. I'm right, aren't I?
It's gonna be the exact opposite. She's gonna be pitifully wrong. Mukuro alive. The one that's still alive is Mukuro? But can we really believe that? No. She's pitifully wrong. It's just proving her wrong. Proving how pitifully wrong she is. How do we do such?
The body we found in the garden. It wasn't Mukuro.
Then she's still alive?
That's right. She made it look like Junko's body was her. So the mastermind's true identity is Mukuro.
What do you say, Monokuma? Do you give up?
Absolutely not. I like how that's a contradictory statement. I love it. No.
The body we found in the garden. It wasn't Mukuro.
No, that's wrong. No, the body we found in the garden was Mukuro. That's one thing we can be sure of. The body's appearance and measurements are consistent with her records. Right, Kyoko?
She was correct. 5'6" tall and weighed 97 pounds. Her vitals were 31, 21, 32. Everything in her profile is consistent with that corpse.
What about Junko?
And then there's the matter of the Fenrir tattoo. So there's no question it's her.
But if Mukuro's not the mastermind, then who's actually still alive?
Someone made it look like they died, but they actually have been still alive. There's only one person that it could be. Well, at that rate...
Here's my answer! Junko is still alive. It's the only possibility.
Are you sure about that?
Huh?
I admit, since Mukuro is undoubtedly dead, Junko does seem to be the only other explanation. But we saw her get impaled. She died right before our very eyes. If Junko were still alive, the death we saw would had to have been some kind of charade. But you yourself confirmed she was dead, did you not?
Now that you mention it, I gently place my hand on Junko's lifeless body. I touched her wrist to check for a pulse like they do in the movies and stuff, but she really is dead. There wasn't anything else to say. She was gone. I did check absolutely, and I can say for sure.
She was dead. There's no question. Junko was dead.
So, the idea that she's still alive...
It must be... wrong.
Then you're withdrawing your previous statement?
I know you gave it your best shot, but too bad. I guess your conclusion was a dud. Too bad, too bad.
This case hasn't been decided just yet.
Oh?
You haven't given up already, have you, Makoto?
No.
No, of course not. There's no way I'd give up that easy.
That's all well and good, but how do you intend to solve the problem standing in your way? Junko absolutely died. Mukuro absolutely died.
Then both of them are dead, right? There can't be any kind of survivor story.
I think we need to look at this from the opposite direction.
Huh? The opposite direction?
Let's assume Junko is still alive. If so, how could she have survived?
How could Junko have survived? I checked her. She was dead, I'm sure of it. But still, if she were alive somehow, could it be that Junko's not the one that died? It wasn't Junko, but someone else entirely. Maybe she used some sort of trick. Oh, Hangman's Gambit again! Whoa! I don't think we've ever had that. P and C. Why are there green ones now? Oh, I was wrong. Okay, never mind. Oh, it's about health. How much health do you have? Okay, it's not their appearance. No, I was not mentally prepared for the Hangman Gambit. Okay. R. Oh, it's replace. P R P L A. A, where are you? Choose replace.
Now I understand. That's it. What if she switched places with someone else?
Switched places?
That's right. Before the spears could kill her, she got someone to take her place. Specifically, Mukuro Ikusaba.
Then that would make it Mukuro's corpse that showed up later.
Which is why the body's height and weight and everything match Mukuro's profile, right?
I don't know anything about this switching places thing, but... that had to be Junko who got stabbed to death, right?
Yeah, you're saying they switched? When could they even have done that? Right when she was about to die? Like she used some kind of ninja replacement technique?
Good point. There's just no way they could have switched like that. So maybe the whole idea is wrong.
There has to be some way. I need to figure out how to explain it. They switched at the beginning.
The two of them may have switched places from the very beginning.
What? From the beginning?
Yes, from the moment we first met. If that's when they switched, then they wouldn't have had to switch at the moment of death, right? After all, the one we saw at that point would have already been Mukuro.
Hold on. So, you're saying the Junko we first met was actually Mukuro all along?
Then, we'd already met her?
I had, like, a normal conversation with her.
When we first met, none of us knew who anyone else was. So Mukuro could have simply told us her name was Junko, and we never would have known the difference. That would easily allow the two of them to switch places from the very beginning.
Wait, but Mukuro had a tattoo on the back of her hand, right? Junko never had any tattoo like that, did she?
She could have hidden it with foundation or something like that. If she did, it likely melted away in the explosion, exposing the tattoo after the body was extinguished. Plus, there were the fake nails found on the hands of Mukuro's body. They were the same fake red nails she was wearing when we all met for the first time.
But if she really did use foundation...
Correct. Even if there was no tattoo on her hand, I couldn't say for certain it wasn't Mukuro. So I'm glad nobody noticed that glaring hole when we were trying to figure out who attacked Makoto.
But too bad for you, Monokuma. You can't deny it anymore.
Wait, so this whole thing was a setup from the very beginning?
If that's true, it was quite an elaborate plan to be sure. Making it look like Mukuro was Junko.
The reason such an elaborate plan was possible is because the two of them were working together.
So Mukuro, the ultimate despair, teamed up with someone like her. In other words, it would be fair to say that Junko herself was also the ultimate despair.
What's wrong? Lost the will to fight back?
I think he's just afraid.
Afraid? What's that mean, afraid? Fear is only possible where hope is possible. I only have despair, so fear is an alien concept to me.
Then why haven't you been saying anything?
Because it's a bunch of nonsense. Junko's my secret identity. As if.
Then why did you try and protect Junko's real identity?
I tried to protect her identity. When did I do that?
He still refuses to admit it, but we can try. He can try and deceive us all he wants. It doesn't matter because I've already figured it out. He tried to hide Junko's identity, and not just once, but twice. The first time was during the latest investigation.
Shoot.
Okay, hold on. Crap. I'm falling apart here. Okay.
Shoot.
Crap.
Shoot.
Wow, I am losing all my health on this. Okay. The first time was during our latest investigation. I'm still gonna die again. It's gonna happen. Unless I somehow luck out and grab the wand. Okay, we checked out. He did. No. Okay.
I refuse to give up yet.
Okay, what am I missing?
Two of them?
What?
Yes, if that... Then they wouldn't have had to... After...
Wait!
Junko, if she did, plus, correct, so, but two,
wait, so,
if that's true,
the reason such a,
so moot, in other words,
what's wrong,
I think he's a prick,
then what, because it's a,
then why did you,
I tried to win,
back to this. Okay. Crap.
Shoot.
I highly doubt this is right.
No. No. What the heck?
Did we check this already too?
No, we didn't. Crap.
Was it actually the dead body?
Shoot.
No. What? I am so... Do I have no evidence to corner Monokuma? I have to. Unless the group photo itself had... Hold on. What matters now is presenting the right evidence. That has to do with Monokuma that tried to keep me from seeing during the investigation. Looks like I just embarrassed myself in front of everybody. Oh, so the group photo is not right. Okay. And... Oh, what? Am I actually gonna go and, like, get everyone wrong? It can't be the DVD. We've already explained why the DVD is a problem. No. What? Okay, wait. Where am I going so wrong? What am I failing to present? Other than the secret. No. What? Is it none of my evidence? It can't be none of my evidence, right? That can't be the answer. Wow.
I was in the AV room, watching the DVD of our interviews with the headmaster.
Oh, I'm cutting the power. Which, of course, meant the DVD wasn't playing anymore. Okay.
You made sure I couldn't finish watching the video. And the reason you did that is because you didn't want me to see the real Junko, did you?
Oh, yeah. If everyone was in that video, of course Junko would have had to show up.
And if Makoto saw the real Junko, it would have been totally obvious that the Junko we met was an imposter.
That whole power outage thing was just a fluke.
It wasn't a fluke. The mastermind definitely orchestrated the power outage. And that's not the only time that they tried to hide Junko's identity. The mastermind tried to cover up one other piece of evidence that I've got to reveal that. Another moment of truth against Monokuma.
Can't hear you. Punishment is waiting for you. That's impossible. I'm not listening. What are you even talking about?
I had to hope that it was group photo. I really had to hope that it was group photo. Anyways, that's why Junko's not there.
The video wasn't the only thing you tried to cover up. You did the same thing with this group photo. I noticed it just a little while ago, when we were all comparing the photos we'd gotten. In all the photos, there's a certain similarity, an unusual circumstance.
What's so unusual about them?
Oh.
I got it! Junko's face. The one thing common to every single photo is that you can't see her face. It's hard to believe her face would just happen to be hidden in every single picture. Don't you think? And on top of that, in this photo, you can see that Mukuro is clearly visible. So in other words, at that point, the two of them hadn't switched yet. With all that in mind, there's no doubt that the girl whose face is hidden here is the real Junko. Which is why you had to have pictures that didn't show her face. Because if we could have seen her face, then it would have clearly revealed that the Junko in the pictures wasn't the Junko that we knew.
Xanadu!
I believe everything Makoto said is true. Junko and Mukuro switched places before we met either of them.
So she killed Mukuro, who had taken her place, making it look like she died. And the real Junko is still alive.
And she's the one behind this whole murderous situation. This killing game. She's the true mastermind. And the ultimate despair!
Xanadu times two!
With this, the identity and the crimes of the mastermind have been exposed.
No! Wait! Hold on!
Don't bother trying to deny it. There's no more room for debate. You don't have anywhere left to run. I'll prove everything. Right now!
Closing arguments!
Oh, wow, okay. This is where the bomb... Get us scared off there. I feel like I'm so off though. I guess we'll see why I'm off. I have some health, so.
We met the ultimate fashionista, Junko Inoshima, but that wasn't the real Junko. The girl we saw before us was actually the 16th student who had taken Junko's place. And that girl's name was Mukuro Ikusawa. But it wasn't long before she died at the hands of Monokuma. In other words, the mastermind, Junko Inoshima. Her body was kept in a biolab, which had been converted into a morgue, until Junko decided to put her body to use. Junko dragged the body out of the biolab, using the tarp to carry her to the garden. She fabricated the murder to try and frame Kyoko, who'd proven to be one big thorn in her side. Meanwhile, she wanted us all to think Mukuro was still alive and hiding somewhere inside the school.
Okay. Am I just pushing everything up? What is this?
Thank you.
gets on.
I don't know if Makoto's slightly wakes up yet, though.
Makoto. Oh, I mean, Makoto could be slightly waking up, realizing. By the time he realizes, Kyoko's there, kicks him out. Oh, wait, no. That picture's already there. Am I right to then assume this course of action? Then Kyoko attacks, he runs away, we see Kyoko. Tarp happens. That makes sense. Body's dead. Tarp happens. We then see the body, and everything happens from that point. Okay.
Here's exactly what happened.
That makes sense. That makes more sense.
Meanwhile, she...
Crap. Shoot. Kyoko caught them in the act. Kyoko made them leave. We had the knife there to begin with. And at that point, it has to be the mask.
The killer is you! Meanwhile.
No. Wow. I think I deserve like a C or a D on this trial. Jeez. I really did not. I've not done well at all on this trial. They have switched. From that point. This happened. Oh, this can't happen. This is already in the book. Okay. Do we really? Okay, Act 2 is nothing that we have to worry about. Act 3. Act 4. Act 4 is where things get really interesting because it's like, what am I missing? Does the knife have anything to do with what is going on at this current moment? No. Why not? That's Junko. That is not Makoto. But what is here that is not what I'm doing wrong? Could it do with the book? Put it here. Then the two Kyoko things happen. Oh, wait, no. That's when the Monokuma bomb. Oh, no. The stab hadn't happened yet. It's okay.
The killer is you.
I'm wrong, I think.
We met the ultimate fashionista, Junko Inoshima, right after we all arrived, but that wasn't the real Junko. The girl we saw before us was actually the 16th student who had taken Junko's place. And that girl's name was Mukuro Ikusaba. But it wasn't long before she died at the hands of Monokuma. In other words, the mastermind Junko Inoshima. Her body was kept in a biolab, which had been converted into a morgue, until Junko decided to put her body to use. Junko dragged the body out of the biolab, using the tarp to carry her to the garden. She fabricated the murder to try and friend Kyoko, who proven to be one big thorn in her side. Meanwhile, she wanted us all to think Mukuro was still alive and hiding somewhere inside the school.
See, this is what's confusing me right here. What could and would potentially happen? Like, right
exactly
after this.
What happened.
It's not the knife. We already tried that, I believe. Oh, what? So he never tried it the entire time? Is what you're telling me? Is I literally made up that I tried that note? No! Oh my god, so I literally had that. Okay. I cannot believe that. I made that up. But I made it. I thought I... I saw I did. It was the other way around. It has to be. Meanwhile.
So she put on a mask and then attacked me. After making sure I'd gotten a good look at the mask, she left the room.
Okay. So this is where she placed the mask on the victim. Ah, that makes more sense. Okay.
Sure is. You. After making sure I'd gotten a good look at the mask, she left the room. Then she put the same mask on Mukuro's body. This was all to make us think the person who attacked me and the corpse were one and the same. She wanted us to believe the murder had only recently taken place. Finally, by strapping a bomb to the body, she was able to destroy any remaining evidence. She needed to hide the body's true identity. She had to make sure we didn't find out it was actually the same person we'd met in the beginning. This is the truth behind Mukuro's murder, and the one who carried it all out is the true mastermind. The one controlling Monokuma. The real Junko Enoshima! That's the whole story behind this incident. Well, what do you have to say to that?
What? Are you broken again?
You can't get out of this.
Come on! It's time you finally revealed yourself!
It's not like you're an endangered species or something. How long do you plan to keep hiding?
Give it up, Junko. The game's over.
Over? Did you really think the story would end once we reached the climax of the case? Wrong! There's still plenty more to go!
Ultimate Despair, Junko Ishin... Oh my gosh. Okay, wait, okay.
We have been waiting so Whoa. Many peasants like you to appear.
What?
If you swear your fealty to us, we will reward you with half of the entire world. We've even drawn up the deed already. We will grant you honor, status, in some of our home cooking.
She sounds so different.
Have you made your choice? Will you serve under us?
Oh, did you think I was being serious? Sorry, I was just messing with you. It's been so long since I've had an audience. Even I'm not sure what kind of role I'm supposed to play.
This is the mastermind. She's the real Junko Enoshima.
Anyway, looks like I've finally been set free. Having to play Monokuma all the time, day after day, it was like I was stuck in purgatory, or like a slow suicide. I get bored so easy, you know?
Your face!
Huh? What about my face? What's wrong with my beautiful face? People have told me I'm cuter than 100 chihuahuas combined.
I feel like this isn't the first time I've seen you.
No, I do remember seeing it. I'm sure I have seen her somewhere too. Where was it?
Shoot! I got it! That's right. It was before I ever came to this school. I remember seeing a magazine cover. And you were on it.
Wow, you have a pretty good memory. I guess that's why you've made it this far, huh?
So I was right. Then what you told me in the main hall when this all began...
I've seen her on tons of magazine covers, but I feel like it doesn't quite match up to reality. Huh? Oh, you're talking about the cover photos and junk? Well, of course, those are totally photoshopped. Photoshopped? Yeah, you know, edited to hell and back with, like, computers and junk. Oh, so they aren't real?
Sometimes a little lie is necessary to keep things moving along. Wouldn't you agree?
That explains why she didn't quite seem the same. Because she was a different person all along.
I'm me. And Mukuro is Mukuro. She tried her best. But there's just no way she could have passed as the ultimate fashionista. Two people can never become one as long as the walls of mind and body exist. Not even if they're twins.
Twins!
I know, it's such a cliche, right? I'm almost embarrassed to admit it. So basically, Mukuro and I had your stereotypical twin relationship. The older sister, tough and proud. That was Mukuro. The younger sister, smart and cute. That was...
Me! Junko fucking Anashima! And together, we were the Despair Sisters, aka the Ultimate Despair!
She's a totally different person now!
Oh boy.
Like I said, I get bored easy as hell! I even get fucking bored with myself!
But if you're twins, why do you have different last names?
Ugh, that again? You have any idea how many times people ask me that shit? Maybe it's new to your dumb ass, but it bores me to tears. Answering the same questions over and over? Just make up whatever answer you want. I don't give a shit. The truth's fucking lame anyway.
But if she was your twin, that means you killed your own sister?
And for reasons deeper and darker than the ocean. Ha! As if!
Well, I suppose I'd better explain. For my plan to work, someone had to be able to control the killing game from behind the scenes.
She keeps changing herself. What the heck?
The so-called mastermind had to operate Monokuma, keep an eye on everyone, things like that. But after looking at the situation, I determined it would be impossible for Mukuro to perform such duties. Because naturally, she turned out to be the letdown of the family. Leaving me behind to run off and join some band of mercenaries. Such a disappointment. So, I decided to play the role of director and have her join the rest of you in your school life. I could have let her work alongside me, but she would have been useless to me that way. Besides, 15 students seemed like a solid number to start with. Of course, the fact that she was the ultimate soldier posed something of a problem. She had what I call the three atrocities. Atrociously rank, atrociously filthy, atrociously repulsive. It was atrociously clear just how out of touch she was with the rest of society. Meanwhile, my ultimate fashionista status has an undeniable appeal that I didn't want to go to waste.
And that's why you switched identities?
Sadly, her inability to match my personality was even greater than I'd calculated. It was a lost cause. She was nothing more than a bit player, an extra, unworthy of lines. Being the utter disappointment that she was, anyone would have expected her to get killed off right away. Which is precisely why I killed her. To meet everyone's expectations.
That can't be your only reason, can it?
Well, no, of course not. I also did it to avoid becoming bored.
I've never been a stickler for following a plan to the letter, you know? If I planned everything out and knew just what was gonna happen, that'd be so boring.
Oh my goodness.
So I changed things just a bit and decided to use Mukuro to make a little point.
In other words, Mukuro's death was a one-sided, premeditated act of betrayal. Just as I suspected. When Mukuro was killed, she must have been as surprised as anybody else.
What? Huh? This wasn't supposed to. Why? Me?
So you figured it out? Well, you're right. There's no way Mukuro could have pulled off such a convincing performance.
But she did teach you all a very valuable lesson, don't you think?
How can you talk like that? You sacrificed your own sister. How does that not even bother you?
What? I sacrificed her? That's what's got you so hot under the collar? Jeez, misunderstandings sure are scary. We were the ultimate despair, you know? So we never had any kind of hope or expectations. Nope, I felt despair as long as I can remember. Like I never should have been born at all. When I was born, I cried tears of total despair. So that's why for us, it's not a big deal whether we die or kill. We're just those kinds of people. We can do anything. We've always been filled with despair. So when we do something, we go all the way and live without regret.
So you just murdered your own sister and didn't think anything of it?
That's not true at all. We were twins. How could I not be sad? That's why it gets me so excited.
Huh?
Killing my precious sister with my own two hands. That act is filled with so much despair. You can't help but put a super in front of it. It's like super, 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 super despair. No, more than that. Super, 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 super despair. It just feels so good.
What the hell is wrong with you?
And my sister, too. In that moment of death, I think she must have felt that despair. After all, to be murdered by your own sister, and only as an example to someone else, she must have died feeling such excruciating hopelessness. I'm so jealous of her. Super jealous.
I knew you couldn't be just some ordinary person. You're some kind of abnormality.
Turning your own despair into some kind of fetish. Abnormality doesn't even begin to describe it.
Like, Genocide Jill is crazy for sure, but this is a whole nother level of nuts.
You're saying I don't compare to some lowly beast that can only kill the weak, right? So I'm hopelessly attractive, hopelessly brilliant, hopelessly athletic. I'm the hopelessly perfect ultimate human.
No, I don't think there's anything perfect about anything you just said.
Yeah, Master's way more perfect. Because on top of everything else, he's got that noble blood.
Toko, on top of everything else, he's got that money.
Don't you mean had that noble blood?
What did you just say? What do you mean by that?
You still haven't figured that part out yet? Man, you guys are so slow. You haven't even solved all the mysteries, and yet here you are, yapping away!
Are you talking about our memories?
You've already solved this mystery, right? I'm the killer, so how about the next one? Maybe you should solve the riddle of your missing memories. Then you can start gloating.
Damn straight! That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to solve all these mysteries.
In the next episode, because it's already been a whole ass hour. Thank you guys so much for watching. We just uncovered the mastermind, and now we gotta solve all the mysteries. What a crazy trial. I in no way, I was all on the hero train. I was like, hero, if the hero's the mastermind, makes sense to his character. No, he's just playing dumb. We figure, you know, every time we try and give him a glimmer of hope, we get proven wrong. We should have already, like, taken that possibility out the window. But the fact that Junko is the one is absolutely insanity. She was one of the ones, one of the deaths that I reacted so hard to in the very beginning. So that's even crazier to me. Like, this just shows how good they did on that. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you guys in the next episode, which will probably be the end. I really hope I'm not leaving you guys off on, like, a 20-minute or at the end. But I have no way to know. I'm sorry, guys.